was also an excellent opportunity for all the forces to analyze the capabilities of each other's fighters. Jets such as this F-16, some of which targeted the IAF Sukhois in these exercises, are now on offer to the Indian Air Force in their latest variant. Another sign of the evolving strategic equation between India and the United States. For the Indian Air Force, exercising against jets such as the F-16 is an invaluable opportunity. Widely considered one of the most maneuverable fighters in the world, the F-16 has evolved into a state-of-the-art multi-role fighter. For US Air Force personnel, flying with and against the Indian Air Force's Sukhoi 30s goes a long way in helping them evolve tactics in countering a variant of the same fighter being used by the Chinese Air Force. In fact, American aviators remain awestruck at the Sukhoi, perhaps the first generation of Russian-designed fighters to be more than a match for the best fighters countries like the US and France have fielded. But if the Sukhois were the cutting edge of the Indian Air Force in these exercises, it was these giant transports and tankers which did a lot of the hard work. Not just transporting heavy equipment to the exercises, but refueling the jets in the air as they made the long journey from India. Getting these lumbering jets up in the air in extremely hot conditions is never easy. At the Nellis Air Force Base, the temperatures during the exercises were even hotter than the hottest air bases in Rajasthan.
It's difficult to explain just what it's like to be in the middle of the Nevada desert on a day when it's 48 degrees centigrade. To be operating aircraft in this temperature is an exceptional challenge. Jets like that heavy transport behind me of the Indian Air Force have been flying day in and day out for these exercises. Maintenance and getting these jets in the air has been a key factor in Red Flag 2008.
We have been operating in very harsh conditions here in terms of the temperature, and the elevation of the Nellis Air Base is quite high. So as for any machine for that matter, when the temperatures are high and the elevation is higher, it has its effect on the performance of the aircraft. Out of the air crew, I've got three more pilots with me, three navigators, one signaler, one flight engineer, and the gunners. And they have been flying every day, flying the mission, which involves a cycle of about 12 to 14 hours, and they have performed commendably well.
But Red Flag wasn't only about fancy flying. In a modern air-land battle, offensive missions are conducted by several forces, including highly trained commandos. The Garud Force is a new Indian Air Force unit. Trained to operate deep behind enemy lines, the Garuds can rescue a downed flyer or take out high-value targets such as airfields. At Red Flag, these Garud commandos were airdropped in the middle of the desert and had to navigate their way to their targets.
Garud Force is a special force of the Indian Air Force, and primarily our roles are combat search and rescue, MPDR bursting, and these are the combat roles. While we were undergoing the training, it was actually very tough, but then once you actually accomplish the training, and after that you really feel good that you've achieved something good. But then another thing in the special forces is that the training goes on. Every now and then you have to undergo these training to make yourself fit the kind of scenarios that have been painted here. And we worked out in the urban terrains, the kind of infrastructure they have got here. They exposed us to all these kind of infrastructure, and it actually gave us a lot of training value.
Ultimately, though, Red Flag is all about where India sees itself as a future military power. For the first time, the Indian Air Force has the reach to travel anywhere in the world and the firepower to carry out any offensive mission required of a major air force. War gamers and strategic analysts know that unilateral Indian military action other than in a war along our borders is unlikely. What is more likely is for the Indian Armed Forces to be part of a multinational military coalition. The red flag has gone a long way to show that from a military and operational standpoint, the Indian Air Force is right up there with the best in the world.